The L.A. Kings have had many celebrity guests, but they were mere mortals. Tonight, a man who is more man than the rest gets his turn. Because tonight, it's Ron Burgundy night. You stay classy, Los Angeles.
All the way from San Diego, as we welcome you into a special edition of Hockey Night in LA, presented by Attendee.com. Alex, Jim, and Ron.
And we are about to begin the second period. Why don't we take it away, gentlemen, and turn down to the ice.
Yes.
San Jose Sharks versus, of course, your LA Kings.
So I guess you're going to do play-by-play here,
I'm going to attempt to do a little play-by-play here.
I see.
I used to do some with the San Diego Gulls
in
the IHL. Of course, they were horrible. Most of the team didn't actually have skates.
I see.
They just run around in their gym shoes on a slippery ice. Right now, Kings had, a fairly strong first period. Got some shots off. 15-7 in shots, right?
Is that what I'm reading? Outstanding period.
Yes.
They're outstanding.
And here we are controlling the puck, passing over to, who was that guy?
That'd be Sean Walker.
Sean Walker, one of my favorites. Moving across, and we've got some moving into Brownie on the attack here into the defensive zone for the Sharks. San Jose Sharks. They
like
are
guys,
94 points, I believe,
not
right,
bad.
In the Western Conference.
Not bad at all.
Number four in the league, of course. They have yet to win a Stanley Cup. San Jose Sharks have never won a Stanley Cup.
Could you say that one more time?
Shot on goal, Walker. Kid out of Ontario, right? He's got to be out of Ontario. Is he? Or Michigan?
Could be both.
Ontario, Keswick.
Oh, okay.
You've been there?
Yes. We've both been there, Foxy.
Hockey Mecca, Keswick, Ontario.
You and I shared a couple of Molsons.
I only had one.
You only had one. Nope. And I had 15. Kings on the breakaway. Here we have a shot on goal. Save by Martin Jones. Martin Jones, former Kings player,
if
I'm correct.
Yep, yep.
He enjoys, what he does in the offseason. He works with puppets.
He does?
Yes.
Is he a puppeteer?
He's a puppeteer. And I've been to one of his puppet shows. They're actually quite good. This is really a wonderful vantage point. You guys must never get sick of this.
Best.
I myself feel a little bit nauseous, and I hope I don't throw up during the broadcast.
But if I do,
I'm going to throw up right on Foxy.
That'd be fine. That's okay.
It's happened before.
It's happened before?
Oh, yes.
Oh, really?
During
a broadcast, yeah.
When I talk, people throw up all the time.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
It's actually a physical reaction. Something's happening. Down in the end, the Kings, of course, have recommandeered the puck. And now they're moving it up the ice to Foley, over to Benson, back to Foley, over to Haver. He's looking for Havershaw. No. Foley through the zone, dumps it in. I believe that was a dump. Foley again. Oh, big hit by Carter. Jeff Carter. He is a statuesque man. I once saw Jeff Carter with his shirt off in the locker room.
You did? What was your reaction?
He's got the goods. Oh, shot on goal! Carter, just as I was talking about. But, of course, another save by Martin Jones. Who's 19 for San Jose there?
That'd be Joe Thornton.
Oh, Joe Thornton.
Big Joe.
Duck Dynasty Joe Thornton. That beard. Apparently, someone found a corn dog in Joe Thornton's beard during the intermission break.
That's not all they saw.
There's a lot of old remnants of food in Joe Thornton's beard. San Jose working it around, taking a few shots. But what a, pad save! And cleared by the Kings. Take that, San Jose. Zero Stanley Cups. Zero Stanley Cups for the San Jose Sharks. They wouldn't even know what the Stanley Cup looked like if it fell on their head. Kopitar, now with the puck. skating through center ice, drops it off. Shot on goal.
You're not bad at this run, I gotta
say. You know what? I feel very relaxed.
Like riding a bike, right?
Yeah. It's like riding a bike.
Did it before?
Well, you guys know.
Now,
someone just handed me something.
Yes, they did. We're going to read that card that was just handed in a moment. If you want to read it, you can. You're allowed. Just wait till we get a whistle.
Okay.
You know.
Here we go. The card will be read.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that was not supposed to happen.
I'm going to take that card out of your hand, Ron.
That was number 48, Tomas Hertl.
He has really improved his game this year, Ron.
He really has.
Good save.
I mean, a wonderful save. You can't ask more than that. And then little back pass.
Oh.
Screened by his own man, right?
Use the defenseman as a screen. Watch this. He'll shoot right between the legs.
A little tweener.
Yeah.
And then what can you do? Well,
it happens.
It does happen. Unfortunately, we're down 2-1.
You know, it's a possibility that all that saying that they had zero Stanley Cups, you could have jinxed them. You know, you could have jinxed the Kings.
Well, I don't believe in superstition.
Well, that's good. Then both of us are on the same page in that.
I don't believe in that, even though I have worn the same lucky underwear for every broadcast I've done.
Really?
Yes. I had to keep it together with staples and duct tape and shred it.
Must be uncomfortable with those.
It is uncomfortable. The more I think about it, I try not to think about it. Shot on goal again. We've got to put that man down. You know what I mean? San Jose. You guys have been to San Jose.
I know the way there.
Yes. It's a lovely town, right?
It is.
Alex?
It is a lovely town, and they have...
It's no San Diego.
It is true that it is not San Diego. It's San Jose. Share the same first name, though.
A lot of room there because they don't have any cups taking up the...
That's right. Oh, look at this.
Oh, you're on the video
board. You pre-taped
it. I didn't authorize this.
Oh.
Go, Kings! Go, Kings, go! Come on, people! No one's listening.
Are you? They can listen to the TV, though. They can hear. And
I hope the TV audience was hearing me.
Exactly.
Would you be known as a homer as an announcer?
I would. Well, do you mean would I pull from the team that I was announcing for?
Yes.
Oh, hell yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes. No, when it comes to announcing sports, I have zero journalistic integrity.
But you have journalistic integrity the rest of the time.
The rest of the time, I'm aces.
Because you're a serious professional and can handle anything thrown at you.
Pretty much. Pretty much.
It's kind of a big deal.
Well, I did say that in the documentary film that was made apart about my life.
Was that a word?
Is Toffoli Italian? Is he an Italian player?
I believe he's from Canada.
Oh.
I have him here from Scarborough, Ontario, another Ontario boy.
That's the Italian part of
that's known as the Tuscany of Canada.
Correct.
Now, as you made your way from the Forum to Staples Center here, were you listening to one of your podcasts on the way? This is something that
I was listening.
Has come up
recently. I have the Ron Burgundy podcast out now, available on wherever podcasts are available. I still don't. Tomas Hertl, the announcer just said.
All he had to do was listen to you.
Okay. Yes, I already gave that information.
He's way behind.
Yes, we've started the Ron Burgundy podcast, which is fascinating. You can download these podcasts and download them to your phone and listen to them. When they first approached me about doing a podcast, I was like, okay, how are we going to do this? Do we record it on a cassette tape and then just drop it off at people's houses? And they said, there's a lot easier way to do it. Kings had a chance there. Poked away.
I did it today, and it took me 8 seconds.
8 seconds, and isn't that wonderful? And we have stimulating conversation and wonderful guests, and it's really been a wonderful new chapter of my career.
Now, the most important question that I had on my mind was,
right,
what do you think of Jim Fox's hair?
Jim Fox, I mean, Jim Fox has got amazing hair. Gorgeous, luxurious.
I'll share a secret with you in a moment, Ron, about my hair. It's something I don't tell a lot of people.
Foxy, do you use a lot of product? You're not afraid of the product.
I do. Yeah. Product goo is good.
I use Pennzoil.
Uh-huh.
Motor oil.
Yep.
Just a little bit, not too much. Oh, there's a slap shot by Thornton. Now, he reminds me of a Swedish player, Swedish national player from the 60s, Emil Wohl, a defenseman, who was actually neutered in a game against Hungary in the Innsbruck Olympics.
Ooh.
I don't know if you guys remember that.
Was he penalized for it, or did he get a penalty on the play?
He did not get the ref didn't see it.
Oh.
Wow, Quickie lost his mask there.
Snapped it.
Now, what's going to happen there?
Yeah, you just blow it down.
Okay.
Put it on. And we come back in a couple seconds.
We're going to come back for, wait, right after this, back with more Kings hockey. Ron Burgundy.
Hey, Ron Burgundy. So we heard that you're announcing a Kings game tonight.
We wanted to wish you luck, have fun, and
stay classy, Ron Burgundy.
How nice is that?
Wow, doesn't get any better.
And you know what's wonderful about that is that that's the first time that Miss Universe and Miss USA have been in the room together in a long time. They've been feuding recently.
Really?
And it's just great to see them bury the hatchet, so to speak.
See, this is the great type of information we get from a proud newsman like you.
Exactly.
I heard about a feud recently. You and Diana Ross kind of not kicking it off well? Or
Diana Ross.
I know
Ross,
it's tough for you to talk about.
Well, I used to date Diana Ross, and she dumped me. This was a while ago.
Right.
And I've never let go of it. It's been it's been contentious, at least on my part. From what I hear from Diana's people, she doesn't remember who I am.
Was there a restraining order involved? Or?
Well, I'd rather not talk about it on the air.
Legal?
It's still pending.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, my tip for the hair, Ron, is this.
Yes, what's your tip for the hair?
I know you've done before.
Sure.
I take my headset
right
to the gentleman who cuts my hair and put it on so he can
and
cut around it.
And then you shape the haircut around the heads. Alex, do you do the same thing?
You know what? I'm picking up notes as I go here.
Experience.
That's one of the greatest things I've ever heard in my life.
I want to share it with you because your hair is just impeccable.
Oh, no. Break. Trip him. Trip. Yes. Quick with the pad save there on the arm. The blocker, right? The blocker? I believe it's called a blocker.
Oh, yes, it is.
I'm surprised Quickie didn't go Ron Hextall on him and chop him in the legs, you know? For those of you who don't remember Ron Hextall, he wasn't afraid to get into the back of your... I just was brought a bean burrito and a glass of milk.
Oh, not
two of your
Bailey.
Favorites.
Thank you so much, Bailey. I really appreciate that. I'm sorry I yelled at you in the hallway walking up here, but you scared the living bejesus out of me.
He tends to do that.
When a six-foot lion appears out of nowhere and doesn't say anything, it's weird.
Well, you've had experience with zoo animals before.
You don't mind if I bite into this burrito right now, do you? Oh, my God. Yeah. No. That is delicious.
Now, while you're eating.
Alex, get into that burrito.
I'll get into that burrito.
Get into that burrito.
Just a moment.
Oh, I want some.
A
little burrito?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I do have a question because I'm fascinated here. First, the tip about the hair and all the other things I'm picking up here.
Right.
Like eating a burrito on the air. You know, I'm a newcomer, relatively speaking. Is there any advice you can offer to someone like myself who has not quite as much experience in the broadcast world as yourself?
Well, you just got to, you know, relate to the people, relate to the audience, and don't be afraid during a telecast, no matter how exciting the action is on the ice, is to tell personal stories about your life. Just interject at any time, and because that's what the viewer or the listener is going to remember at the end of the day.
I have to take notes on that.
Yeah.
Personal stories.
For instance, I remember the time Foxy, you remember this. It was you, me, Bernie Nichols.
Remember that?
And
another good head of hair.
A great head of hair. And Don LeGay.
Ron Duguay?
Ron Duguay.
Yeah, Ron Duguay, yeah.
He said it a couple different ways, depending on where he was.
Ron Duguay. And we all went down to Tijuana. And the rest, I don't remember. But look at that head of hair.
Nice, that's good.
Ron had a head of hair that rivaled Jim Fox's head of hair, which was also outstanding.
And both from the same hometown, Ron and I.
Did you guys know each other growing up?
Oh, yes.
Were you arch enemies?
No. We're kind of. He's a little bit older than me, you could tell, right?
But gosh, he was a heartthrob, if I remember correctly.
Oh, yes.
And you were not, my friend.
And still not.
But he had the hair.
He had the hair.
And he did have a perm back in the day.
I like this kid, Kempe, the Swedish kid.
Yes. That would be Kempe. Adrian.
Adrian Kempe.
You know, they just did a poll, NHL players.
Okay.
Who has the best hair in the league.
Oh, who
and four of the top five were Swedes.
See, the Swedes know what you're doing. They know what they're doing. I mean, that's
Vidal
Sassoon country.
Do you have any Swede in you at all with that head of hair?
I am.
I know you and Odin. I'm you not, follow Odin quite a bit.
I quote Odin a lot. Yeah. I'm not necessarily. I do have, oddly enough, I'm 37% Dutch.
Ah.
So I did that thing, the where you swab the inside of your mouth.
Yeah,
the,
exactly. Yeah.
The DNA test.
Yeah, the DNA thing.
Yeah.
And I was mostly Dutch and Portuguese, oddly enough.
Oh.
So.
And the name.
Oh, like, right across. Oh, something happened.
With a name like Burgundy.
Oh, little tip shot. With a name, you would think I was from France.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh.
You know what? Bailey brought me this ice cold cup of milk, and guess what? There's vodka in it.
Really?
And I'm not going to send it back.
I thought you preferred warm milk.
I do. I prefer warm, room temperature to hot milk.
Gotcha.
And if it's buttermilk, I won't say no.
Gotcha. And do you still carry a flask everywhere you go?
Yes, I do for emergencies in case I'm, lost or can't get out of my car in sub-freezing temperatures. I'll have a little nip from the flask. What sort of formation would you say the Kings are running right now?
That would be the 1-2-2.
Are they running? Well, we're going to go to another break.
Again, yeah.
This producer keeps talking in my ear.
Yes.
Okay, we'll be right back.
He tends to do that.
Right after this.
Patrick O'Neill down here on the ice, and we have Ron Burgundy up in the booth. Ron, if you don't mind, if I could also ask a question of you. I know we're
certainly.
Thank you. We're hitting you up big time. You know, I get an opportunity to interview celebrities, A-listers, movie stars down here at the game, and sometimes I'm confused.
Well, I'll be the judge of that.
Well,
continue.
Well,
yes.
Let me know. Like, I had James Caan one time.
Oh, that Jimmy Caan, classic.
I know you go back. Yes. So what advice would you give me to get a celebrity, a top movie star, like, out of his shell to have a good interview?
Well, Patrick, I met you earlier before the match,
and
to be quite honest, and I hope you take this the right way, you need to change your cologne.
No.
You need to switch it up to a Drakkar Noir, or maybe a
Tiger, the Tiger one.
The Tiger one. Love Sex, right. Sex Panther, something like that.
Yeah, thank you. I'll try.
Which has real bits of panther in it, and it's mostly gasoline. So,
is that why you put the in your hair the? The Pennzoil?
The Pennzoil and the gasoline really mix together. Now, I can't get near a match within 1,000 feet.
Yeah.
But
must make starting your car pretty difficult.
When does the Kiss Cam start?
Oh, that's...
I don't know.
You know?
Get it on.
We might have to buzz upstairs and see if we can get that.
Because I'll kiss this burrito on camera for the Kiss Cam if it happens.
Quickie just lost his mask again. Second time.
Second time. How many times have you seen a goalie lose a mask in a game?
Not twice.
Not twice, right? That's a good omen.
If you say so.
No, watch. See, great save.
There you go. See, I'm just learning on the fly here.
Now, is that not a penalty if the goalie loses? I mean, that's very dangerous if you lose the mask. Or is that a self-inflicted...
They'll blow the whistle. They'll blow the play dead if it's a danger to the goaltender. If it's an immediate scoring chance, they'll let it go.
Now,
Gentlemen, I have to ask you about tonight's promotion, which I thought was very strange. Bring your stray cat to the game tonight. There have been, for those of you at home, we've had to stop action on the ice several times. Yeah. Feral cats have run onto the ice. Why would the organization promote bringing stray cats into Staples Center?
It's been a tough year, Ron. So any promotion to get people in the building, it's been a tough year.
Well, stray cat night is a weird one.
Yeah.
Unless the stray cats were going to play here after the game.
You know, that's possible. They do have groups that come out and play before and after Kings games.
So maybe the stray cats are going to be playing. Wow.
Yeah.
That's a newsflash. You heard it here. Stray cats will be playing after the game here at Staples.
That might make the 11 o'clock news in San Diego.
Oh, it will. It will. Now, when will the Kings start running an octagon formation? Does that exist in hockey?
It does.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of you have to wait till you're
there. There we go. Just freeze it. Freeze it in the boards. You can't freeze it anymore like you used to back in the day.
Right. He used to blow it down.
Yep.
Keep it going.
Oh, got to keep it in the zone. Come on, fellas. Here we go. That was a nasty little check from behind. I don't think that was a how you do. Icing. San Jose iced it.
I'm absorbing so many things here tonight,
right.
But among LA's greatest broadcasters, you have Vin Scully, you have Bob Miller, of course, late Chick Hearn, Ralph Lawler with the Clippers, Dick Enberg with the Padres. Who is your favorite among these legends? And where do you think you rank among them in terms of the South?
I am very much in their shadow. These are all legends.
Yeah.
Of course, I think you gotta throw in Don Cherry up there.
Yeah.
Hockey Night, right? And your guys' colleague Darrell Evans.
Yes.
I mean, the way he dresses.
Oh gee.
He is a real champion.
He is.
Does he make his own suits?
He does not. It looks like it
looks
sometimes.
Like
yes.
They're poorly tailored.
Yes.
Yeah.
But there's Darrell.
There he is.
He's got look at that. The,
right next door the radio
violet,
booth.
The violet kind of color.
Always with the pocket square. Natalie attired. Great to see.
You got some new threads, looks like, here.
Yeah.
This is a really sharp looking suit.
I decided to, it's from the... It's from the Katy Perry JCPenney line.
Gotcha.
Katy Perry's going into men's clothing. Little known.
Nice.
Little known fact.
We'll check that out someday.
You should.
It's really sharp. And what was the origin of the turtleneck? Was that just a style of the time that kept on going,
that
or is there some other significance?
Well, as you when you look around the arena, most people are wearing turtlenecks. It's come back so strong. In fact, I'm counting, let's see, one. At least 700 people I can just see right here wearing turtlenecks. And it's just a look that never went out of style.
Producer's counting again.
Oh, they're counting again.
Yeah, so we can leave the break.
We're going to go to break. We'll come back with more Kings hockey right after this. It's the first time I've ever been on the Kiss Cam.
And you've asked for the stray cats, and guess who's playing?
And look, this is one of the greatest nights of my life. I got to kiss a burrito on the Kiss Cam, listening to the Stray Cats.
Man.
If only the Stray Cats themselves were here. Oh my gosh, they're here. They're behind us, guys. Don't look. I'm just kidding.
You had me there for a second.
This couple.
Oh.
They cut to them every time.
Renowned.
Are they just longtime season ticket holders?
I don't even think they're married. I don't.
Oh, there's a shot on goal by Martinez. But it didn't happen.
Now, I've been waiting.
Yes.
And in the final 5:22 here, I hope that we get to hear it. But if we do get to hear, what would your goal call be?
I feel like if I do it now, I'm going to jinx it.
That's
for the Kings.
Yeah, okay. You don't want to jinx it.
Or would it help them score?
I don't believe in jinxes. I don't know.
It'd be something like this. Kopitar with the puck. He dribbles. He skates up the ice. And says, shot on goal! He scores! Put that baby to bed without a diaper. Something like that.
I like it.
Descriptive.
Yeah. That's a little Chick Hearn in there, you know?
Oh, no.
No.
Okay, now we're okay. For a second there. Guys, what? I got to ask you, you're on the road.
Yeah.
41 dates out of the year.
Yeah.
What's your favorite city to travel to?
Oh, gosh. For me, it'd be Montreal.
Let me guess. Buffalo. Oh, Montreal.
Yeah.
Yes.
Montreal.
Oui, monsieur. How about this? Can you read that?
Oh, we've got a wine fest we need to talk about.
Don't
miss the LA Kings Wine Fest on March 30th. Prior to the game versus the Chicago Blackhawks. Come down to Staples Center at 5:30 p.m. That's Pacific time, right?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Yes.
And enjoy a couple glasses of wine on the City View Terrace. Tickets come with an LA Kings stemless plastic wine glass. Not actual glass, plastic. Visit lakings.com/winefest to purchase now. That sounds like a heck of a good time. Mm. You really should have a scotch tasting, though, if you really want to bring in the crowd. Now, what sort of wines will it be sampling?
I will say this. It would not be Burgundy.
No.
Because you would never drink Burgundy out of plastic. Ever.
Ever. Maybe
No.
Maybe a Pinot. Chablis. Pinot Grigio.
Grigio. Tyler Toffoli could probably say
Will there be any Boone's Farm there?
Ooh.
Or Bartles and James?
We're not stepping it up.
Because if they're, I'm there.
See, you lost me with this. Because I just don't know my wines. I don't know my spirits.
Or what was that one wine that used to come in the ceramic bottle that they used to have commercials for? Oh, gosh. Never mind. The Castle. I think it was called The Castle.
It would fit with the Kings, kind of royal
right. Yes.
Theme.
Royal theme.
Go, Kings, go! Go, Kings, go! They can't hear me, can
they? No, they can. They can.
We're too far up. Oh, well.
The fans will get going if you...
Right, exactly. Now, if only you had Bailey's drum, then you
could really
get them going.
San Jose with a shot. Nope, closed down by Daddy. And there's going to be a penalty on the play. San Jose's going to work it around. Oh, the goalie's left. He's quit. He's decided I've had enough. And he's... Oh, no, they brought an extra man on the ice. Sorry, I thought the goalie had left and was just going to run for the showers. And Jeff Carter will be...
Los Angeles, number 77, Mario Pillar for interference.
Oh, interference.
Yeah.
I don't know about that.
Right off to the side here. Watch the... Oh.
No, that's just a little love tap. Do you call that interference?
Timo Meyer, who went down, he was just fined $2,000 for diving. It fits right there.
Well, let's throw him in. Look, that looks like a dive to me.
Yes.
What's the guy's name again? Timo?
Timo.
Well, you can't trust a guy with the name Timo, that's for sure. Popcornopolis penalty kill.
First opportunity for the San Jose power play.
How's the power play kill this year?
Not good.
15th in the league?
29th.
Oh, 29th. Out of 50 teams?
31.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, not good.
Yeah. No. We try to, look at the bright side. It had been playing better of late. A little bit more structure.
A little more structure. Well, they didn't run the octagon. That's why.
San Jose, meanwhile, is sixth in the league in power play percentage.
So they know what they're doing here. Well, I feel like they're nervous, San Jose. They look a little nervous to me. Nice, quick. Take that, Sharks.
I think they're only nervous because they're in the presence of
greatness. Well, I think they can feel it. There we go. Nice work. So the Kings, maybe they're 10 games left in the season.
Mm-hmm.
Looking to build on some high notes for next season, I assume, right? Playing a lot of the younger players.
Indeed.
Right.
And we've got a whole bunch of them that we have looked at over the course of the season. And tonight, 7 defensemen, most of them young players.
Oh, there we go. Just hold on to it. Can you just lie on the puck?
Oh, yeah.
Oh! That would have been a sweet little shorthanded.
9 more seconds. 8 more seconds on the penalty. 7 more seconds. Guys, you're almost there. 5, 4, 3. Keep going, guys. 2. They killed the penalty. Yes. Burritos for everyone.
I don't know if that's a promotion, but you can
enjoy
your
burrito. I was going to try to throw my burrito onto the ice, but I don't think I can make it.
Well, I think you've also had pretty bad luck with throwing burritos at things in the past.
Quick. The Arco top tier play was on the penalty kill, presented by Arco. Here it is. Joe Thornton with a little wrist pass over to some guy,
nice.
62. And Quick just stood his ground and said, no, not in my house. Take your rental car back to Burbank and get on a flight to Southwest back to San Jose, is what Jonathan Quick said with that. He said all that with that save.
He's able to get a lot of words
in a short period of time.
Well, as you know, a picture paints 1,000 words.
It does. It really does. It sometimes paints 10,000 words.
Last minute of play in the period. This is the McFlurry minute.
This is the McFlurry minute.
Yes.
This is where things get crazy.
A lot of things can happen in the final minute of the period.
And so far, nothing's happening. But it is still exciting. I mean, it's really come to a standstill. Well, there's a breakout right there. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Clifford down in the corner. Shoot it! Just shoot! Oh, well, they don't have the puck.
You asked about laying on top of it. I think Evander Kane did that to Trevor Lewis there.
Oh, I feel they might drop the gloves right here for the last 9 seconds. Someone's going to drop the glove. I have a good feet. No. Oh, they're just going to skate it out. Well, that was the close of the second period. Kings only gave up one. Fought off a power play, down 2-1.
Still in it.
Still in it.
Yeah, still in it. And this was just a thrill.
Gentlemen,
for both of
thank
us.
You Pleasure. So much. You know, I've done a lot of things in my life, a lot of things in the career, and this is truly in the top, I think, 1,000 things I've ever done in my life.
Oh, we are.
I put it in the top 1,000.
We are glad to be a small part of it in the presence of greatness. Ron Burgundy, thank you so much.
Thank you, Alex.
Pleasure.
I can smell the
Jimmy,
cologne from here.
Thank you,
Pleasure.
My friend.